Hey, we'd like to invite you and thank you for coming for tonight's Christmas program. I tell you what, you know, the devil does all kinds of things to steal joy around Christmas. And he can even try to use a Christmas program. You know, we have about 25 to 30 kids on any Wednesday night. If you'll notice, we don't have that many tonight. We've got several out sick, and so Miss Pat and I have just really been kind of figuring out how we're going to get this thing off and how we're going to do it. You know what? And God said, this is not about this program. This is about my son, Jesus Christ. And if we'll remember that, you can't take the joy out of a Christmas program. But tonight's Christmas program is called A Bad Case of the Gimmies. You know, and how fitting. Sometimes we just forget what Christmas is truly about. Now, I'm going to ask you to be very careful tonight. We're going to be using both aisles. So if you have to exit, you might want to go down the sides, okay, for some reason. We hope you enjoy it. May God bless us all. All right, Pastor Tim. Will you come and say an opening prayer?
Good evening, welcome. You don't know what you're in for because we don't know what we're in for. But we know that it is a tremendous program with a wonderful story to it about Christmas and the meaning of Christmas. So we ask that you keep your hearts and your minds open and that not you learn from it tonight, but these kids have learned from it tonight. Join with me in prayer. Father, we thank you for this day. And Lord, as Robbie has said, Satan has even tried to get amidst this
Oh my goodness, kids, it's not even daylight yet.
Slow down, it's too early.
This is the worst case of the gimmies I've ever seen.
Gimme.
Kids gimme. Act like you don't know what Christmas is really about.
I know what Casey's favorite thing about Christmas is.
Turkey. Santa Claus? Present?
No, you come here and let me tell you what Christmas is really about.
What in the world has happened to Christmas? Where did Christmas go?
Where are you, Christmas? Why can't I find you? Why have you gone away? My world is changing. I'm rearranging. Does that mean Christmas changes too?
Now, this is the story of Jesus' birth and the real reason why we celebrate Christmas. Now, the birth of Jesus happened this way. When Mary was engaged to Joseph, she was found to be with child. Then Joseph, being a good man and not willing to make her a public example, decided not to go ahead with the marriage, but to put her away privately. But an angel appeared and told him to take Mary as his wife, for she had conceived by the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and his name shall be Jesus, because he shall save his people from their sins. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, to be taxed with Mary, his wife, being great with child. While they were there, she brought forth her firstborn son, wrapped him, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Away in a manger, no crib for a bed.
In the same area, there were some shepherds staying out in the field watching their sheep. And an angel of the Lord suddenly stood before them, and they were terribly afraid. So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in a manger. When they had seen him, they spread the news, and all who heard it were amazed. Even wise men from the far east came.
Wise men saw the child with his mother, and they worshipped him. They gave him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said. The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means...
God is with us!
God is with us!
Good job.
Kids, it's not about the presents or the toys or the Christmas tree, and it's not just about the angels and the shepherds and the wise men. It's about something a lot bigger than that. It's about Jesus being born once so that we could be born again, and it's about God's great gift of salvation that Jesus shared with the world. But a lot of people did not like what Jesus had to say. So they hung him to die on a cross. But for those who believed, he offered forgiveness of sins and eternal life with him in heaven. And God still offers that today. Oh, the beginning of the story is so wonderful, but it's the end that saves us. Christmas is about Jesus. Christmas is about the cross.
Ooh. about the manger, where the baby laid. It's not all about the angels who sang for him that day. It's not just about the shepherds or the bright and shining star. It's not all about the wise men who traveled from afar. It's about the cross. It's about my sin. It's about how Jesus came to be born once so that we could be born again. It's about the stone that was rolled away so that you and I could have real life someday. It's about the cross. It's about the cross. It's not just about the presence underneath the tree. It's not all about the feeling that the season brings to me. It's not just about coming home to be with those you love. Oh. It's not all about the beauty in the snow I'm dreaming of. It's about the cross.
It's about the cross.
It's about my sin.
It's about my sin.
It's about how Jesus came to be born once so that we could be born again. It's about the stone.
It's about the stone.
The cross.
The beginning of the story is wonderful and great, but it's the ending that can't save you, and that's why we celebrate. The cross. Ooh, it's about the cross. Had
a time with this. We have sickness until today. We didn't know if we were going to have a Mary and Joseph, and I thought John and Robbie were going to have to be it. And
they're not the greatest because they mess up and they act.
Oh, he's asking you to sit down.
They just act up and they didn't know their lines. They lost their lines and everything. So anyway, we got it done. And I want you to look on of all these kids. These are our Wednesday night kids. We've got about maybe two-thirds of them here. We've got a lot of sickness. Okay, all the adults, these are our teachers for Wednesday night. And our helpers.
Is your mic on?
It was on.
Is it on? Put it closer to your mouth.
So this is our next generation. This is our church. Now, I've left out one person.
Robbie's our director of Wednesday Night Children's Church. She's the one that keeps us all in line. She's the one that handles all the chaos, and including the chaos.
chaos that we've had for the last month. She is the calm in my storm. I'm anxious. She's calm. So I want to thank her. This is from my kids and me. I want to thank you for just being here.
Thank you, Robin.
Okay, this one on?
I have no idea. We're having all kinds of mic trouble. They can hear me.
Okay, that's going to be happily. I don't know if there's anything in there or not.
That'll be a card. That's enough.
Okay.
Oh, yes, yes. Here. It's the only way I'm going to get you to shake my hand. I may not let go. I know you.
All right, it's on. You guys be seated for just a few minutes. Or if you want them to go sit back down front here, I'm going to tell a story.
We're supposed to stay for pictures.
And stay for pictures. Do not leave. Except for that stray cow. Man. Okay, I got to apologize. Now listen, this will be on Facebook, Lequire Baptist Church page, and it will be on YouTube in a little bit also. However, it was dark, and our video quality is not going to be stellar. However, it's better than what it's been in the past, so I think you'll enjoy that. I want to say thanks to these girls and these kids. Wonderful job. And I want to share two scripture with you. That one of them is traditional Christmas, and the other isn't. And the one that's not traditional Christmas, I'll follow up with a story, a prayer, and you'll go home. Okay? You're all supposed to go, amen. All right, there you go. We all knew, no, Luke, that boy every time. Randy, I think you got him on cue. We know Luke 2, it came to pass. Decree went out from Caesar Augustus. All the world should be registered. This census first took place while Quirinius was governing Syria. All went to be registered, each to his city. Joseph went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, which is the city of David, called Bethlehem, because he was the house and the lineage of David. To be registered with Mary, his betrothed, espoused wife, who was with child. So it was while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered, and she brought forth her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, for there was no room in the inn. You saw that tonight. You saw that portrayed. You see it on the stage, and that's the whole center of it. Why? Why of Christmas? Because John 1:14 tells us, and the Word became flesh and dwelt amongst us. And we beheld His glory, the glory as the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. The Word became flesh, and that flesh was Jesus being born in Bethlehem so many years ago. Let me follow it up with this story. Some of you have heard it. I pray most of you have not, and it will help you understand maybe about the birth of Christ. Albert. Albert was a simple man. He was a very educated man, but he was simple by most people's perception. He wasn't complicated. He wanted a very simple life. He was a farmer and rancher. It was that time of the year, winter, and the snow was falling, the wind was blowing. It was one of those freezing cold nights. He knew that soon his wife would be coming to him and asking him the question. The question of this Christmas Eve night, what would he do? For soon the bells would be ringing and people would be going down the lane. It wasn't the day when everybody just got in their car and drove off. It was the day when you walked most places that you went. You got to love them. And, I mean, you got to love it. Brex, Brooke, and I can't remember what the other B was. Bright. Yeah, there we go. The three B's. We got it. Anyway, they would walk to the church down the lane. His wife came in, and Albert started the fire and sat down and had his warm cocoa with him. And his wife said, "Albert, those aren't church clothes. Aren't you going with me to the Christmas Eve service?" And he said, "Not this year, dear. Not this year. I'm going to stay home if you don't mind." Well, she did mind. But she also respected Albert, had been married to him for many years, and was not going to question him at this time. So with that, she went off down the lane to the church, and soon after she had left, he heard the bells begin chiming, signaling. You remember the good old days with the steeple and the bells ringing, telling you that it was time for church, and that's what was going on. As she made her way to the church, Albert made his way to the kitchen for yet another cup of coffee, contemplating this Christmas thing. You know, Albert had studied and read many times, but he just could not wrap his mind around and conceive this whole virgin birth, and why would God wrap flesh upon himself and come down to this earth to be one of us? He just couldn't understand that. He poured his cocoa, went back to his chair, and sat back, feet propped up on the footstool, threw a blanket over him, and he was settled in for a nice, long, warm evening in front of the fire. And about the time he got settled, he was almost starting to drift off to his sleep, for it had been a busy day. Putting the cattle up, the sheep up, feeding, making sure the barn was secure and everything. And with the brutal cold outside, it did not help. But his attention was quickly taken away when he heard the first smack. And he looked to the window and something had hit it. What could it be? And then it was followed again by another smack. They had a big window in the living room where he was at, and the fireplace was reflecting on it, for the curtains were not pulled back. It got Albert's curiosity up, and Albert walked over to the window, and the time he got to the window, another thump hit that window, and it was a sparrow. And the sparrow was dazed by the hitting of the window, and he thought, well, they must be attracted by the fire and the light and seeking somewhere to get warm. It's so cold outside. How could they not? And then about that time, the bird got up and flew off, and he thought, well, surely now he will go and find some place where it's warm. Only to be followed by less than 5 minutes later, five other birds coming back and all hitting the window one after another. And he thought, what is going on with these birds? Albert put his boots on and went outside, no coat. And he said, "Shoo, you birds, shoo, get away." And they left. And he thought, finally, he no more than got back inside, and the birds had come back once again, only more of them this time. It's like they went out and told others, "We have found the fire. Come now and be where it's warm." And many were back. He went back outside again, and he thought, "I know, I will go open the barn with the lights on, and they will see that light and know there is heat." And he turned the light on, opened the barn doors, and the birds he thought would come, they would not come. He went over and tried to shoo them into the barn. They would not go. Albert was now almost frantic, knowing that if the birds did not get to shelter soon, they were going to die. How could he let this happen? He had to do something, or these birds would perish. And then he thought to himself, if I could only become one of those birds, I could fly into that barn and they would follow me. If I could only become one. And at that time, the bells at the church rang once again. And the scripture that I just read came to Albert, and the word became flesh and dwelt amongst us. And it was at that moment Albert knew why God sent his son, his only son wrapped in flesh to be born in a manger. If God could just become one of us, surely we would follow. We would be saved from our sin. If one could come who was sinless, would we not have any choice but to follow? Albert at that time went in and grabbed his coat, and you'll never guess where he went. He walked to the church. They were singing the song, Silent Night, Holy Night. He walked in and knew his wife's usual spot and grabbed her hand. And they sang together. So if you want the why of Christmas, the other attempts that God had made to bring us salvation through the law, through the sacrifice, had failed. There was but only one way left that God could bring us salvation. And yet, I feel many today are still fluttering around as those sparrows hitting the glass. The answer is found in simply looking at an empty manger and an empty cross. And I pray this evening through the message of Christmas, you do not go away with an empty heart. Would it be tonight that you finally understand the message of Christmas? That He who knew no sin became sin for us? He died so that we would not have to spend an eternal death separated from Him. It's not hard. It's as easy as the ABCs. Admit to God you are a sinner. Believe that Jesus is God's Son. Died on a cross for your sins. Was put in a grave and rose 3 days later. Confess your sins because He's faithful and just to forgive you of your sins. It's that easy. But it's just difficult to do. Throw away the difficulty tonight and find salvation that comes through the birth of a baby. Join with me in prayer. Father, we thank You for tonight and we thank You for each and every one that's here. We thank You for these children and may they understand the message of Christmas. It's not about the presents. It's about the One who is present in our heart. Lord, bless these children. May we teach them to believe. Jesus, thank You for this Christmas. In Your name we pray. Amen. On behalf of all of Lequire Baptist Church, to our guests, we want to say of the most merriest of Christmas to you this year, and to those of Lequire Baptist Church, Merry Christmas to you. And everybody that's here tonight, everybody gets a gift. In the back there are some brown paper bags that have our usual Christmas treats in it. And we want to make sure that you get one for yourself. And if you have a spouse or someone who is not here, please ask them back at the back and they will give you one. And kids, there's enough for you also. We save some back just in case. So, kids, stay for pictures. If you want to take pictures, take pictures. If you want to, whatever, feel free. But the gift bags will be at the back. God bless you guys and Merry Christmas.